and welcome back to Seek the Joy podcast. Happy Seek the Joy Tuesday. I'm your host, Sydney Weiss, and today we are celebrating 4 years of Seek the Joy podcast. 4 years. Like, isn't that bananas? Like, I think it's kind of crazy. I'm trying to like really let the fact that it has been 4 years of this show sink in. And I don't think it's totally hit me yet. I'm actually recording this right now on the actual 4 year anniversary of the podcast, which is October 2nd, 2017. But I thought this year we would celebrate on the first Tuesday of the month, which is the day you're listening to this. So it's pretty surreal to think that 4 years ago, I sat down with my laptop and with the headphones that come with your iPhone and thought I could just record an episode. And I had no idea what I was doing. And then I quickly realized, that's not a great microphone, Sydney. We need to actually get one and really invest in this. And it has been such a journey. Like, it has been such a journey. When I sat down to start this show in October 2017, I could just have never imagined, predicted, or believed like what it is today. Like, the podcast has shifted and evolved. And I know I say this every year, but this podcast would not be what it is without you. Truly. Like, I know there are so many podcasts out there for you to tune into, to press play on, to listen to. I mean, when I started this podcast 4 years ago, there were half as many shows as there are right now. So I'm so grateful that you're here. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for sharing this with your friends and your family, with your coworkers, for pressing play, for your emails, for your DMs, for your virtual hugs, for the friendships that have come from this podcast. I'm so grateful. I cannot believe too just the ways in which my life has changed for the better as a result, not only of Seek the Joy podcast, but I think also of just podcasting in general. So this episode is going to be a big reflection moment. And then at the end, I want to share some news with you, some things to expect from the podcast and all things Seek the Joy as we move in to year 5. So to kick this off, I want to share some statistics with you because I do this every year and every year it blows my mind. So over the last 4 years, I have published over 230 episodes. That's 145 conversations. I've had over 24 conversations for Lessons In, which was a series I launched at the beginning of 2020. And I featured over 293 people on Joy Corner, which is the blog on our website that goes live every Thursday and features two incredible people every week. Like, that's a lot. Like, that's amazing. And part of those 230 episodes are solo episodes and the power of storytelling, which has since retired itself from Seek the Joy and has moved to its own podcast called Stories of Inspiring Joy, which I launched mid-pandemic last year. And so since launching, I have featured over 150 people and their incredible stories. That in and of itself totally blows my mind. Like, I can't get over this. But year 4 brought with it more than just all of these episodes and conversations and a new podcast. With it came our first ever Seek the Joy Summit, which happened back in April. And all of these months later, by the way, I am like still on cloud 9 about this summit because, okay, so Seek the Joy Summit was something I wanted to do like since the very beginning, like when I first launched Seek the Joy podcast, but I knew the timing just wasn't right quite yet. And then the pandemic hit and we were all connecting virtually anyway on Zoom. And I thought, okay, like this is the time to launch our first ever like one day virtual retreat on Zoom. I wanted to celebrate this community and just bring people together from all around the world so that we could connect and inspire and grow. And that's exactly what it was. The day was filled with just such beautiful, empowering conversations and sessions. We talked about mindfulness. We talked about finding our joy and choosing our own sense of positivity and stepping into our authentic voice and the importance of sharing our story. And then there were so many opportunities to connect with this community. And I am still on cloud 9 about the whole thing. And my hope is that in year 5, we get to do another Seek the Joy Summit because it was so good. And the speakers were so amazing. And so if you tuned into the summit, thank you for being there. Thank you for being part of the hundreds of people who tuned in and signed up, which by the way, was also something I didn't expect and totally blew my mind. And if you didn't tune into the summit, send me an email, info@seekthejoypodcast.com, and I'll get you the replay because it was so good. I just want to keep sharing it. So in year five, the hope is to have another summit. I just could have never predicted the response to it and the way we all came together and the magic that literally was like pouring out of the computer screen through all of these beautiful sessions. And then, you know, I got excited again and we introduced our first ever Seek the Joy summer series this year, which I had never done before, but I had this idea. I really wanted to have focused, intentional conversations that could welcome in, I think, the warmth of the summer season. And I think COVID and the pandemic really also inspired this summer series that we put on both as a virtual retreat that you could have signed up for and tuned into. And then I made the decision to share those sessions again on the podcast because I always feel this way. And I'm curious what your thoughts are, but I always feel like with a new season comes a new opportunity to ground into the moment, like to ground into this present moment and set our intentions and reflect and celebrate. And I felt like the summer just felt like such a time and an opportunity to celebrate and to experience joy and to welcome in this new season. And so I put together this beautiful series, I thought, that featured a solstice meditation, yoga flow, sound healing. Then we had workshops on community, sanctuary, tapping into the summer energy, the power of play, and stepping into our self-care. And I left this series feeling so energized and just inspired, and so many of you loved it as well. And I was so excited to do it. So maybe we'll do something like this again next year around the summer or another season. But between the summit and the summer series, this was like the first time that I've been able to connect in a broader way with all of you and with your friends and with your family. And it has been a total blast. I've been thinking a lot about this, you know, the last 4 years and this podcast and this community and the opportunity to connect with so many of you. And I'm always so grateful when I see a new email or a new DM come in and you're sharing how you found the podcast or you're sharing something about an episode that inspired you. It always just brightens my day. So please never stop. Please never stop doing it. But the opportunity to connect with you, I know I said this already, it's just totally changed my life because when I think about the Sydney that hit publish on that first episode back in 2017, like I don't even recognize her. Like, who is she? Like, I don't even recognize her, which I think is such a beautiful gift. You know, audio storytelling, any medium that you use to document a moment in time is so precious. Like, it's so valuable. So the opportunity to go back and listen and hear how much my voice has changed or hear my comfort level has just gone up so much and having these conversations, I just know I've grown and I know I've widened my perspective. I see the world. I feel like I see the world through a more holistic and just community-minded lens. And I know I have this podcast and everything that's come from it and that I've created and all of you to thank for it. And there is not a day that goes by that I am not just so incredibly grateful. I need another word because grateful is not enough. Like, grateful is just not enough. But when I think about year four, the word, or maybe I should say words because it's more than one word, but the word that comes to mind or the words that come to mind are joyful resilience. Like, if I had to sum up this last year of Seek the Joy podcast, it's joyful resilience. The last year tested me. I think it tested you too. It rocked me. It brought me like immense sadness, but also incredible joy. And I learned so much about me. And not to make this sad because this is a celebration episode, but grief has a funny way of teaching us a lot about who we are. And our grief asks us often to look at our own vulnerability differently. And so after my grandpa passed away, October 13th, 2020, so we're coming up on the 1 year anniversary, which is really weird. Like, time flies. Time waits for no one, like truly. But after he passed away, it really asked me to push through my own discomfort, to look at areas in my life that have been, I think, unexplored. And then, you know, you kind of put like reflections and themes and understandings to the back burner because life goes on. And then this all came back to the surface again after my grandma Pearl passed away this past August. And so while navigating a pandemic, while navigating a drop in my own mental health, while there were still so many beautiful, positive changes and opportunities happening in my life, both with friendships and at work and this podcast, I keep coming back to this lesson of pushing through my discomfort, this understanding of pushing through my discomfort, of looking at the areas in my life that just have not been explored. And this podcast has helped me do that. And the conversations we've had over the last year have 100% helped me do that. I think about the conversations we've had since last October. I mean, they are freaking beautiful. We had conversations on spirituality with Amy White and Liliana Barzola. And then Audrey Ori came on and we had this incredible conversation about being an ally and pushing beyond, I think, the box that we often look at storytelling in. And then we, you know, we dove in the new year into setting goals with Larry L. Lipkins, and Lauren Martin, the author of Words of Women, came on. And, you know, there's so many conversations. We talked about female friendships with Danielle Bayard Jackson. We talked about the Enneagram. We talked about the Enneagram a lot this year, by the way, with like Christina Wilcox. And then it just came up in other conversations too. Lindsay Gardner came on. She's the author of Why We Cook. It was an exploration about food and feminism. My friend Vryn came on and we had such an awesome conversation about dealing with uncertainty. And again, the Enneagram came up. Melissa Bernstein, co-founder of Melissa and Doug Toy Company, came on to talk about her new book, Lifelines. I mean, the list goes on and on. We talked with Jimena Bengochea in July about how to become a better listener. I just cannot get over these conversations. And then August, we dove into grief with Krista Couture and Kat Peters. And all of these conversations have just left such an amazing, profound impact on me. And by the way, I love what we just shared in September. Leah Van Doren came on to talk about creativity. Athena Laz, all about dream interpretation. And then Lisa Barnett with the Akashic Records, which, why did it take me so long to talk about the Akashic Records on this podcast? And so we have just had so many incredible conversations. And I've had the best time this year sharing all of them. And then sharing with you all of the conversations and the sessions from Seek the Joy Summer back on the podcast was so much fun too. And I heard from so many of you about the way these sessions just impacted you. But I'm going to be honest, I hit a level of burnout this summer that I have never experienced before, to the point where I sort of found myself going through the motions with everything I was doing, from work to the podcast to friendships to family to everything. And so that's why I keep coming back to this word, or these words, this phrase, let's say phrase. This is why I keep coming back to this phrase of joyful resilience. I don't love the word resilience, by the way, because in order to know that you're resilient, it means you have to be tested. Like, it means that you've gone through some stuff. So maybe a better word or a better way to look at it is that you're in the arena of life. Like, you're here, you're showing up, you've got both feet in, you're not running away, you're here, you're participating, you're taking risks, which, by the way, I don't like taking risks. And that's something I'm currently exploring, is this element of risk taking in my own life and like being okay with uncertainty, which not the best at, but that will come in a future episode. But joyful resilience means to me that you've got your feet in the arena. You're here, you're letting yourself love and be loved. And so you have to go through it to know what you're made of, to, I think, understand your own kindness and compassion and empathy. And at the same time, the other side of that coin means you're going to feel hurt and disappointment and loss and grief and sadness and every other emotion that pops up in between that entire spectrum. And so over the last year, I've done exactly what I wanted to do, by the way, because in last year's episode, if you go back to our 3-year celebration anniversary episode, I shared that my intention was to continue to share conversations that showed we can hold joy and hope and love and connection in one hand, and at the same time, we can hold loss, difficulty, and discomfort in the other. It was my way of wanting to push beyond and push back against really this element of like toxic positivity that's so prominently out there. I don't believe that joy comes at the expense of other emotions. I think we can hold them both at the same time. And I think so much of this life, for me at least, and I'm curious if this resonates for you too, I think that so much of this life is about figuring out how we can hold all of our emotions and experience at one time. How we can think about everything as a party guest walking through the door. Your apartment, your home is filled with everyone, every emotion. And you have the opportunity to sit with what you want to sit with, but they all exist at the same time. And so these conversations and moments over the last year have been so powerful for me. I mean, as I was going through and looking at all of the episodes and conversations and the reflections I had typed out for each one, I'm just so astounded and so grateful. And I just hope that these conversations have been that for you too. I shared this in last year's celebration episode as well, but I just know that if we can continue to tune into our joy, if we can continue to tune into our passion and allow our life, allow our friendships, our connections, our relationships, our work, everything in between to be an expression of that joy and passion, life is going to be so much more beautiful and full of possibility than I think we could have ever imagined. But even beyond that, we can have such a large impact on our lives and then by extension on the lives of those around us just by coming back to our own self-understanding and joy and passion along the way. I cannot wait to see the inspiring, impactful, and just powerful conversations that we're going to share in year five. It's actually very surreal to me to even say, oh, year five, we're entering year five, because I never in my wildest dreams thought that we would be going into the fifth year of Seek the Joy podcast. And I'm so excited, and I really hope that you are too. I just had this idea, so I'm Googling it right now as we speak, to look up the numerology or the importance or significance, I guess you could say, of the 5 year, because we're entering the 5 year right now with Seek the Joy podcast, and I'm recognizing that 2021 is a 5 universal year. Okay, Sid, note to self, let's have a numerologist on the podcast in year 5, because I have so many questions. But here it says, in numerology, the number 5 represents the energy of instability. Change is its key mandate. The emphasis during a 5 universal year is pushing boundaries, exploration, and new ideas embarked upon with an adventurous and fearless spirit. To make the most of a 5 year, expect and embrace the unexpected. Okay, I kind of love that. Like, I kind of love that, and let me tell you why. Because as we enter year 5 of the podcast, I am going to be making some changes. And it's going to start with me taking my first ever hiatus from Seek the Joy podcast. In 4 years, I have never missed a week. There were some times where I had a week around the holidays where I didn't publish a new episode, but I have never missed a significant chunk of time in publishing new content, in recording new episodes, and having these conversations. And going back to what I was sharing a moment ago about being so burned out and being so tired, I realized I need to take a break. Like, I need to hit pause. I need to take a refresh period for myself. And so from now until the beginning of December, there will be no new episodes of Seek the Joy podcast, but I am going to be airing, how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Yeah. Okay. I'm counting in real time right now. I'm going to be releasing 8 best of episodes. And these are episodes that you have loved. These are episodes that my grandma Pearl loved. These are episodes that you all loved in year 4 and beyond of the podcast. And so while I take a little rest behind the scenes, you get to still tune in to super amazing episodes. Some that are from early days of Seek the Joy podcast that you might have not even knew about. And so I'm really excited about this. I'll be back publishing new episodes at the beginning of December. It'll likely be a new conversation and also my usual end of year recap that I always do. And then when we come back in 2022, I'm going to be making a little bit of a change there as well. Stay tuned for that announcement while I figure that out behind the scenes. The podcast, okay, let me say this. Seek the Joy podcast, stories of inspiring joy and Joy Corner, everything in the Seek the Joy universe right now is not going to go anywhere. Like, don't worry. I can see so many of you sending me a text, a DM, or an email right now being like, Sydney, WTF? What do you mean? Like, you're taking a break. Nothing is going to go away. I just need a break. Like, I need a little mental vacation because I think all of you know this, but I do this entire podcast by myself. Like, I am a one-woman show from coordinating the guests to preparing for the interview to recording to editing to putting all the social content together. It's just me. And I also work full time. And I'm no longer working from home, by the way. Like, I'm back full time in the office. And so I just, I need a little break. I need some time to reassess how I want to do everything moving forward. I have no plans to stop the podcast or Stories of Inspiring Joy or Joy Corner because truthfully, I love it way too much. And it's this creative outlet and opportunity that has something I can't imagine my life without right now. So we'll be back in December. And as I said, we'll be back. Of course, my brain goes to King George and Hamilton. So by the way, I went back to Hamilton, to theater, to Broadway for the first time in September since the pandemic. And it was just as amazing as I remembered. But I digress. So listen, we're going to be taking the next 2 months off. You're going to have best of episodes to tune into, which I know you're going to love. It's my first hiatus ever, but I just know it's going to change my life and it's so needed. And thank you in advance for your kindness and your understanding and for continuing to tune in. And hopefully you'll get a refresh on some episodes that you've heard, others that you haven't heard quite yet, and you'll find new people to connect with and be inspired by. I feel like I say this at the end of every celebration episode, but I really believe that this podcast and this community is just getting started. I have really big dreams and really big plans for what I want to do, and I'm just so blown away by the last 4 years and by your support. And from the bottom of my heart, thank you. So I'm going to end this the way I end every celebration episode, which is just to say, here is to powerful storytelling and to powerful conversations that continue to inspire us and empower us to really doing the work through connection and community and conversation to uplift one another's voices, which is something I feel like we're doing through this podcast and the Seek the Joy universe, and choosing, I think, unapologetically and sometimes with a lot of fear, courage, and necessary vulnerability to step into the fullest expression of who we are, all to seek our joy. So while I'll be taking my first ever hiatus through December, there are so many conversations that are so beautiful that I'll be resharing, and then others that you can go back to tune into and revisit. And just so grateful that you are here. And I would love to hear what you think about this one, this episode, this celebration. Hit me with like your biggest takeaway from the podcast over the last 4 years, or what episode has really stood out to you? And are there themes or conversations that you would love to see us explore in year five? Send me an email, Sydney@seekthejoypodcast.com. I will get back to you. Let's have a conversation. As always, I just can't wait to hear what you think about this one. So make sure to join the conversation on our social media channels, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn. We are at Seek the Joy Podcast everywhere. Make sure to hit subscribe on our new YouTube channel. I guess I can't say it's new anymore because as of December, it'll be a whole year of having this YouTube channel, but I have loved sharing these conversations, like the video. Like, you can see us having these conversations, and it's just so much more fun, I think. But listening to it as a podcast is also fun. So make sure to hit subscribe to our YouTube channel. What else? I think that's it. Oh, if you're enjoying this podcast, you know I got to do it. If you're enjoying this podcast, leave us a 5-star rating and review on Apple Podcasts. And then take a screenshot of that rating and review and send it to me, Sydney@seekthejoypodcast.com. I will send you something to say thank you. And it's always just such a fun way for us to connect outside of the show. Hit follow or subscribe wherever you're tuning in right now so you don't miss any of these best of episodes that are coming up or any episodes in the future. So thank you. Biggest hugs ever. I wish I could just, I wish I could get everybody that tunes into this podcast into like one stadium together and give you all a hug, but I think it would take me days. It would take me days to hug everybody, but that's a dream. Something maybe that will happen one day. I don't know. I think that's it. Biggest hugs ever. Thank you for, as always, for being here and tuning in and listening. And I will see you right back here next week for another Seek the Joy Tuesday, but best of Seek the Joy edition. Bye, everybody. Have a great rest of your day and week, and we'll talk soon. Seek the Joy Podcast is a production of Seek the Joy Media and created, produced, and hosted by me, Sydney Weiss. You can tune into all of our episodes on your favorite podcast platform. And if you're enjoying the show, hit follow and leave us a 5-star rating and review. Make sure to join the community, join the conversation on our social media channels, Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and LinkedIn. We are at Seek the Joy Podcast everywhere. And don't forget, you can actually watch today's new episode and all of our episodes on our brand new YouTube channel. Click that link in the show notes to subscribe and tune in. As always, thank you for being here. Thank you for listening. And I'll see you right back here next week for another Seek the Joy Tuesday.